When a band announced they're reuniting, all sorts of thoughts start going through our heads. Will they still have the same sound and abilities they had when they were in their prime? Will they make new music or just play shows? Or will they make something that completely blows our minds and becomes one of the staples of their discography? Let's take a look at some of the bands we think made incredible comeback albums after reuniting. But before we call it a comeback, make sure to subscribe to APTV and turn on all notifications so you never miss a video. And check out the link in the description to the Spotify playlist featuring all of the artists on this list. 10 bands who released incredible comeback albums. Number 10, Despised Icon. Montreal deathcore OG's Despised Icon ended on a high note in 2010. And for a long while, it seemed they wouldn't be coming back for anything. Eventually though, some of the members got the itch to return to the stage for select shows in 2014 and came up with a fantastic album in 2016's Beast. In 2019, they went back to playing shows a few times a year and had another new album, Purgatory, drop last November. Number 9. LCD Sound System. Dance Punk's LCD Sound System were hugely influential in the post-punk revival, and their farewell show at Madison Square Garden was nothing short of spectacular, lasting roughly 3 hours. For years, fans were eager to see them return, and they got their wish once 2017's American Dream was released to critical acclaim. Number 8. Underoath. Metalcore vets Underoath sadly broke up in early 2013, and while we got some cool new projects from the members in their time away from the band, nothing ever quite hit as well as the original band. They came back for their first return show in 2016 and eventually dropped the insanely good Erase Me in 2018. Number 7. Alice in Chains. The death of vocalist Lane Staley can't be overstated enough in Alice in Chains' career. But a few years after introducing new frontman William Duvall, the band made another record. 2009's Black Gives Way to Blue was a powerhouse album that's fantastic from beginning to end and led to the band becoming full-time again. Number 6. Bleeding Through. Playing in a band isn't particularly glamorous these days, especially if you play in hardcore or metal. Lack of financial support and declining turnouts at shows led to Bleeding Through calling it a day in 2014. Despite reuniting for a benefit show in 2016, it took another 2 years until they came back with an incredible record in Love Will Kill All, and they still perform occasionally. Number 5. Daughters. Mathcore act Daughters had a strange sound that developed immensely over the course of their career, but fights between band members eventually led to their dissolvement in 2009. They started playing shows again in 2013, and after a few years of doing so, they came back with 2018's critically acclaimed You Won't Get What You Want. Number 4. Refused. While they were never particularly huge when they were first around, Refused had a huge effect on music. Rumors started spreading around 2010 that they might reunite, and after playing select shows in 2012, they properly came back with the incredible Freedom in 2015. Number 3. Faith No More. With the amount of new projects Mike Patton offers his fans, it's pretty easy to forget about new Faith No More material. The band reunited in 2009 though, and after 6 years of sporadic tour dates, they returned with Soul Invictus, marking their first new album since 1997. Number 2. Black Sabbath. With years passing by without a new Black Sabbath album, fans were mostly happy to see Ozzy Osbourne make more solo records and occasionally get together for a Sabbath tour. That all changed when the band announced their impending end and created the phenomenal 13. Number 1. Glassjaw. Veterans of the post-hardcore scene, Glassjaw fans had been anticipating a new album from the band for well over a decade. Once they returned from hiatus, we got a few new songs and EPs, but in 2017, the band finally delivered Material Control, and it was well worth the wait. Whether it's better than their 2002 record, Worship and Tribute, is debatable, but it's easily some of the best material the band have made. What's your favorite comeback album? Let us know in the comments below.